Good morning, students. In our last class, we have completed B reading Antony's speech. So I think you all have started writing the question answers and other grammar and vocabulary part of the last unit. So I want you all to write and send me without fail. I am not getting any response from your end. So I want you all to write and send me. So today we are going to start the new lesson. It is from the unit 8. The theme is travel and tourism. In that, A reading is the accidental tourist. So before that, here they have given a image, travel and tourism. Look at the pictures and answer the questions that follow. So what type of images you can see here, children? Yes, we can see Char Minar, temples, and church, isn't it? So what are these all called? They are tourism places, isn't it? So they are asked, see the first question. What are these pictures about? The pictures are about tourist attractions or tourism. This I have already mentioned you. And the second is, have you ever visited such places? We all have visited our famous this Char Minar and other, not only the Char Minar. There are so many tourist attractions in nearby places of our town itself. So we all have visited one time or the other, isn't it? So yes, we have visited such places. So see the third question. In what way are these places worth visiting? So in what way these places are worth visiting? The places are worth visiting for their temples, monuments, places of historical significance. So now moving to the lesson, the accidental tourist. They say that the world today is a small place because travel has become easy. But now everybody finds it easy to travel. Here, the author reflects humorously his experience as a traveler. So now it is very easy that we can reach any part of the world and we can visit the tourist places in the whole world. But in olden days, it was somewhat difficult to reach those places, isn't it? So they say that the world today is a small place. Why? Because we can reach any corner of the world in few hours itself. So because travel has become very easy, so we can reach any part, but not everybody finds it easy to travel. So though it is easy, though we have facilities to reach any part of the world, but it is not easy for everyone to travel, isn't it? Some because of their time or financial position or different reasons, but it is not easy for everyone to travel the whole world. So here the author reflects his experience as a traveler. Here the author is giving us his experience as a traveler in this story. Of all the things I am not very good at, living in the real world is perhaps the most outstanding. I am constantly filled with wonder at the number of things that other people do without any evident difficulty that are pretty much beyond me. I cannot tell you the number of times that I have gone looking for the lavatory in a cinema, for instance, and ended up standing in an alley on the wrong side of a self-locked door. My particular speciality now is returning to hotel desk 2 or 3 times a day and asking what my room number is. I am, in short, easily confused. So what he is here, the author is telling that of all the things he is telling that I am not very good at living in the real world. So he is perhaps the most outstanding. So he is telling, I am constantly filled with wonder at the number of things that other people do without any evident difficulty that are pretty much beyond me. So he is telling that he was not very good at living in the real world. Means we will tell you to be present in the class physically, to be present in the class mentally but not physically. So even you people also, you will be sitting in the class but you are not aware that what is going on in the class sometimes. So even this person also, he was not good at living in present world. So he is constantly wondering that how people can do things very easily without any difficulty which is beyond to him. So I cannot tell you the number of times that I have gone looking for the lavatory in a cinema. He is telling that he has forgotten where the lavatory means washrooms, where washrooms are there in cinema hall. He forgot and he is telling, see, I cannot tell you the number of times that I have gone looking for lavatory. Means he was unable to find where the washrooms are in the cinema hall. For that he used to go round and round for so many times in search of washrooms. So, and also for instance, and end up standing in an alley. Alley means a narrow passageway between or behind buildings. So what he used to do? He used to search and search and he ended up standing in an alley on the wrong side of a self-locking door. So, you all know that we can find people instead of using washrooms, they pass here and there. So, as he didn't find the lavatory in the cinema hall, what he did? He went to a narrow path. It may be between the two buildings or backside of the building, and he used to pass. So that too at the wrong side of a self-locked door. And my particular speciality now is returning to hotel desk 2 or 3 times a day and asking what my room number is. So how much he is confused means he can't even remember the room number in his in the hotel room. So he used to go every time help this hotel desk in sense reception. So he used to go to the reception and he used to frequently ask his room number as he can't remember it. So I am in short easily confused. To say in one word, he is a very confused person. I was thinking about this the last time we went in family on a big trip. It was at Easter and we were flying to England for a week. When we arrived to Logan Airport in Boston and were checking in, I suddenly remembered that I had recently joined British Airways frequent flyer program. I also remembered that I put the card in my carry-on bag, and here's where the trouble started. So he was thinking about his last time he went en famille, means with one's family on a big trip. So it was at Easter. Where did he fly? Means where did he go? He went to England for a week, and when he arrived at Logan Airport in Boston and were checking in. So even when we you know about checking in, so When he reached the airport, he were checking in and he suddenly remembered that he had recently joined British Airways frequent flyer program. So as he was very much interested in traveling, so he joined British Airways frequent flyer program. So, and he also remembered that he has put that card in his carry-on bag, and that is where the problem has started. The zip on the bag was jammed, so I pulled on it and yanked at it with grunts and frowns and increasing consternation. I kept this up for some minutes, but it wouldn't budget. So I pulled harder and harder with more grunts. Well, you can guess what happened. Abruptly, the zip gave away. The side of the bag flew open and everything within, newspaper cuttings and other loose papers, a 14-ounce tin of pipe, tobacco, magazines, passport, English money, film, was extravagantly ejected over an area about the size of a tennis court. So what happened? The zip on the bag was jammed, means the zip was not opening. So what did he do? He pulled on it and yanked at it. Yank means to move slightly, as it is not open, getting it is not having free movement on the zip. He was trying to open it slowly with the grunts and frowns. Grunts means a short low sound in the throat to show pain and anger. See, suppose when your zip got jammed, when you try to move it, a different sound will come. So he, even here also, when he was trying, that sound was coming, and increasing consternation. Consternation means surprise or shock or anxiety. So he kept this up for some minutes, but he wouldn't budget. Budget means to move slightly. Though he tried, it was unable to move. So he pulled harder and harder with more sounds. Grunts means sounds. Then what happened? Well, you can guess what has happened. It will means the zip will get failed. So abruptly, the zip gave up. So what happened? The side of the bag flew open and everything within, means whatever the contents in the bag, were everything fallen down. So what was the things in the bag? Newspaper cuttings and other loose papers and 14 ounce tin of pipe tobacco and magazines, passport, English money, film, all these were in the bag. So was extravagantly means very extremely ejected over an area about the size of a tennis court. So all the things in the bag, when he tried harder and harder to open that zip, the zip gave up and everything present in that was fallen down on the floor about an area of the size of a tennis court. I watched dumbstruck as 100 carefully sorted documents came raining down in a fluttery casket. Coins bounced to a variety of noisy obliviances, and the now lidless tin of tobacco rolled crazily around the concourse, disgorging in its contents as it went. So what happened here? So when even you all know, if anything, suppose your bag zip has failed and you were trying to pull it out and it got failed and it has opened, So it may be books or lunch box or money, whatever is there in your bag. When it falls down on the floor, it will give a different type of sounds, isn't it? Even here also, he has watched dump struck as 100 carefully sorted documents came running down in a fluttery cascade. So you all know, even you will also sort your books. But suppose if they fell down, which type of sound will come, you all know. And also coins bounced to a variety of noise. If you leave some coins, means if you throw some coins on the floor, you will get a different type of sound, isn't it? So here also a variety of noise, obvious means a state in which one is not aware of what is happening around. So he is unable to realize what is happening, means within a fraction of seconds this everything was done. And now lidless tin of tobacco rolled crazily across the concourse. Concourse means the open central area in a large public building. So there in the concourse, this tobacco was rolling crazily. Disgorging means pour something out in large quantities, and also its contents as it went. So what happened when this lidless tin of tobacco fallen down and it was rolling? While it was rolling, whatever the content in that tin, it is falling here and there. So, "My tobacco," I cried in horror, thinking what I would have to pay for that much tobacco in England, now that another budget had come and gone. And then changed the cry to my finger, as I discovered that I had gashed my finger on the zip and I was shedding blood in a lavish manner. Means I am not very good around flowing blood generally, but when it's my own, well, I think hysterics are fully justified. Confused and unable to help, my hair went into panic mode. So what happened when that tobacco was rolling down? He cried in horror, means he was shouting, seeing that "my tobacco," thinking what he would have to pay for that much of tobacco in England. So now another budget had come and gone, and then he changed the cry. So first he was crying in sense he was shouting "my tobacco," then he has changed his shout, saying that my finger. So what happened to his finger? "As I discovered that I had gashed my finger on the zip and I was shedding blood in a lavish manner." So what happened? His finger got struck in that and he was bleeding. So confused and unable to help, my hair went into panic mode. Means when you are in tension, fear, you'll be panicked. So he was confused to help, he was unable to help, and his hair went into panic mode. So it was at this point that my wife looked at me with an expression of wonder, not angry or exasperation, but just a simple wonder, and said, "I can't believe you do this for a living." So what happened? At that point, his wife was watching him with an expression of wonder. Means as he was behaving in that way, his wife was in a shock. Means she was wondering why he was behaving in that way. And she didn't get any angry or exasperation, means irritation, but just a simple wonder we can see on her face. And what did she say? "I cannot believe you do this for a living." So I think you have understood the lesson till here. Students, find hard words from this lesson. You write and you have to send me. We'll be completing the remaining part of the lesson in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.